The big breaking story from the banking sector this morning in New York happens to be the exit of Citigroup CEO Vikram Pandit, the India-born banker who made headlines for becoming a global Indian, who was first stuck with a bank that was partially nationalized and needed to get outside of the banking crisis, and then one that has survived it. Many people call Vikram Pandit the survivor of that crisis, but today, in what has been a very sudden move, Vikram Pandit, along with his chief operations officer, John Havens, both have now quit the company. Well, there's been speculation that this came as a huge shock to employees because people are talking about how this was not signaled within the organization. Analysts are also questioning why would Pandit and his immediate deputy leave at a time when the bank was already showing that it was on a complete changed wicket, that they had already posted a good quarter in terms of results, that net margins were looking good. Why would they want to leave? So as far as analysts are concerned, and as far as, well, so far since we haven't had much out from Citigroup in terms of it being on the record, the reasons for Pandit and John Havens' exit, what we do know is that there's a lot of political speculation around this piece about the exit. Vikram Pandit has had several issues at hand that he's been talking to the board about, but often and again, shareholders and analysts have been talking about an uncomfortable relationship between the board and Vikram Pandit himself. So it seems like somewhere that has reached a peak, and that's what is being talked about as of now. There are various reports that are talking about an important issue that John Havens and Vikram Pandit are the two men who ran the bank literally. So for two of them to leave at a time like this, would this have an impact on the bank? The share is down, of course, this morning in New York. But what is the key issue? How will the bank move forward? For that, they've already announced and elected. The board has elected Michael Kordat, the man who heads European and African operations for the bank, as the new CEO. The suddenness of the situation is what is taking analysts by surprise, and many believe that this might have been extremely planned, but planned just over the last 48 hours, because reports also say that at the IMF meeting in Tokyo last week, there was Vikram Pandit and there was Michael Kordat together at that IMF meeting. Plenty of speculation still around till Citigroup's Vikram Pandit himself comes out to talk, but one thing is pretty clear is that the bank, since the time he took over, has changed tremendously. In the last 2 years, my own interviews with Vikram Pandit have suggested that he's in many ways happy to have been a survivor of this crisis than one who went down with it. But yes, of course, there have been plenty of different views within the bank as to whether the bank survived it well enough. I guess we'll be waiting for all the latest information on that. For now, it's me, Shelly Chopra, reporting here out of New York on a very important banking news day.